Fusion composition or adjustment clip? When do you use one and when do you use the other? And what's the actual difference? In this video, we will break it down in the simplest, most practical way possible. Alright, grab an adjustment clip and drop it onto your timeline above your footage. Think of the adjustment clip as a floating canvas that sits on the top of your video. Whatever design you build isn't on your footage itself, it lives safely on this canvas. Alright, let's click on your adjustment clip and choose Open in Fusion. You will see the good old media in and media out nodes already hooked up. Let's build a quick pop-up text animation. First, grab a text plus node from the toolbar and type in your text. Connect it to the main pipeline so it shows up in the viewer. Then style it the way you want. Alright, let's animate it. Select your text node, go to frame 0 and in the layout tab, reduce the size just a little and add a keyframe. Then head over to the shading tab. Set the opacity to 0 and add a keyframe there too. Now move 5 frames forward, bring the opacity back up to 1 and increase the size all the way to 1. Next, move 2 frames forward and slightly reduce the size again. And that's it. We have got a clean little pop-up text animation built right on our adjustment clip. Alright, back to the edit page, and there is our text animation sitting nicely on the adjustment clip above the footage. Maybe you don't want it at the start, you want it at the very end. No problem. Just drag the adjustment clip over and boom, it plays at the end. Want it across the whole video? Stretch the clip and it stays visible all the way. Think of it like a sticker. You can peel it off and stick it anywhere on your timeline. Now let's make it reusable. Select the adjustment clip, go to the inspector, click the little file icon, give it a name, let's call it pop-up, and drag it into your power bins. Done. Next time you are in a new project, just pull it out of power bins and drag it on your timeline. Hit play, and boom. And here is the best part. It's still editable. Right click, open in Fusion, and all your nodes are sitting there waiting. Change the text, swap the colors, tweak the font, even adjust the animation. Alright, now let's build the same text animation, this time on a Fusion composition, and see what's the difference. First, delete the adjustment clip and the footage from your timeline. Now, bring in a Fusion composition from your effects panel and drop it on the timeline. Right-click it and choose Open in Fusion. Looks a little emptier than before. We don't see media in plus media out here, only media out. Why? Well, because we have no footage on the timeline. So instead of using footage as our canvas, we will make our own. Grab a background node and in the inspector, set the alpha to 0 for transparency. Connect background to the media out. Now we have got a transparent canvas ready to build on. Next, bring in your text node. Type in your text. Let's call it Fusion. And connect it to the background node. From here, you can style it however you like. Color, font, size. And just like before, we will set up the same simple pop-up animation we built on the adjustment clip. So at frame 0, shrink the size a bit and add a keyframe. In the shading tab, drop the opacity to 0 and keyframe that too. Now move forward 5 frames, bring opacity back to 1 and bump the size up to 1. Then just 2 more frames, reduce the size just a touch. And done. We have got exact same pop-up animation, this time built on a Fusion composition. So select all the nodes that make up your design, right click, go to macro, create macro. A new window will pop up with a bunch of settings and checkboxes. Give your macro a name, let's call it pop-up text. And I will only expose the important stuff like text, font, size, style, and placement. That's all I really need. Finally, save it into your macro folder. And boom. You have now got a drag and drop template ready to use in any future project. Hope this breakdown cleared things up. If you found it helpful, don't forget to hit that like button and subscribe for more DaVinci Resolve tutorials.